TFNN. Headline news update.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN headquarters in St. Petersburg, Florida. 2 p.m. Eastern time on Tuesday, 2 hours left to go in the trading day, and we got markets floating around flat territory. S&P's currently negative by 1 point, trading at 2790. Dow Jones positive by 6 points, trading at 25,812. NASDAQ positive by... excuse me, Dow is negative 6 points, NASDAQ positive 6 points, trading at 75.84. Dollar index up about 160 ticks, trading at 96.770. Notes and bonds, a little bit of lower price, higher yield. 10-year note, negative 1 tick, 121.26. 30-year bond, negative 6 ticks, 144.07. Gold contract, flat at 1287.20. That's had some volatility today. We'll jump over to that chart in a moment. And oil, negative 6 pennies at 56.53. We'll start it off. Let's jump over to the future charts. We'll start it off with the indices, and we'll start it off with the Dow, 25,816, pretty much right in the middle of the trading range that we've had today, and not that big of a range considering where we were yesterday. You're looking at 25,860 being the top on a few different occasions, 7 a.m., 11:45 a.m., 1:15 p.m., and then on the lower end, about 25,750 maybe, 760, so only about 100 Dow points throughout the day. And to back things up for some context, there's your slide yesterday. We're up there at 26,125, so the market still a solid 300 Dow points from where we were trading at just at 9:45 this morning. NASDAQ 100, pretty close to the same, approaching those upper levels, 71.66, high for the session, 71.76, so 10 NASDAQ 100 points. And again, in context, kind of right in the middle of that collapse yesterday. S&P is trading at 27.91. Yesterday's action, again, right in the middle of that slide that we had yesterday starting at 10 a.m. There's your crude oil market, was above 57 briefly, back down at 56.58. Gold contract spiked lower at 10 a.m. to about 1282.69. From there, we're up a bit, 1287.40. And euro, U.S. dollar, a little bit of dollar strength. Euro weakness, euro trade 1.1306. And in terms of what we have happening else in the world, how about GE? Talk about a collapse here. As their CEO coming out with news that the market does not like to hear in terms of profitability, so forth, GE continuing to struggle, down 6.4% today, and to bring it back, we'll put it on a 3-year weekly. Quite a chart, folks, quite a chart. Stay tuned. We've got our man Dave White coming up right now with the Power Trading Hour. Tom O'Brien at 3. Have a great Tuesday.